So whether you think Congress is behaving well or badly, whether it's popular or unpopular, if you want a dictator, then you subvert the ability of Congress to hold the accountable, to hold the executive in check. What is central here is, do we want a dictator? No matter how popular he may be, no matter how good or bad the results of his policies may be, no president is supposed to be a dictator in the United States. When I hear colleagues of mine arguing that that Congress is unpopular and therefore obstruction of Congress is a good thing, this shows terrible ignorance or lack of care for our institutions, for our democracy, for our form of government, for our liberties. I, for one, will protect our liberties, will do everything I can to protect our liberties, our democracy, our free and fair elections, and the separation of powers that says Congress and the President and the judiciary check each other, and nobody can be a dictator. I yield back.
Mr. Chairman.
And I,
Mr. Chairman.
I now recognize Mr. Johnson. For what purpose does Mr. Johnson seek recognition?
Strike the last word.
The gentleman is recognized.
Mr. Chairman, I would speak to the Gates Amendment, which is why we're here right now, but I wanted to address what you just said. I think that's a really beautiful argument. I think you should make it in court, because that's what you're supposed to do under our system. If you want to make that argument, you're supposed to go to a federal court, the third branch of government, to resolve a dispute between the executive and the legislative. That's what's always happened before, but you guys won't do it. You could go make that argument, but you're not going to do it. You know why? Because you guaranteed your base you'd get an impeachment by December, by Christmas.